Cell phones are our window to the wider world, but sometimes that window gets fogged. If you've ever struggled with your iPhone's touchscreen, this video is for you. But if you haven't, stick around because it can happen to anyone. Hey everybody, I'm Trisha Hirschberger and today we're talking about touchscreens. What goes through your mind when your iPhone screen suddenly stops responding? Confusion? Panic? Frustration? After watching this video, hopefully your second thought will be to try one of these tips instead of shelling out for a brand new phone or launching the offending device through the nearest window. You've probably already checked this, but just in case, is this problem limited to a specific app? If so, the fault is probably with the app and not the phone. Try swiping out of, then reopening the app first. Some wired peripherals can have unfortunate interactions with the iPhone's general functionality. Try disconnecting any accessories attached to the phone and see if that's the cause. Is your iPhone overheating? If it's hot to the touch, the system might not be working as intended. Try shutting it down for between 15 and 30 minutes so it can cool down. One issue with touchscreens is how much dirt they accumulate. A dirty iPhone screen affects the phone's ability to identify changes in charge, meaning it won't respond to your touch. Only cleaning your phone screen will fix this problem. A clean microfiber cloth is the best way to handle this. Turn your phone off using the force restart, dampen your cloth, and thoroughly wipe the screen. Turn it back on and see if it now responds to your touch. If that didn't work, the problem might still be software related. Even with their proprietary operating system, iPhones are not immune to software glitches that can temporarily disable touchscreen functionality. 99% of the time, a restart is all it takes. However, with your touchscreen unavailable, you'll need to perform a force restart. Simply press and quickly release the volume up button, then the volume down button, then press and hold the side button until the Apple logo appears. Still no joy? Time to look at updating. Hard, but not impossible to do while the touchscreen isn't working. Connect your iPhone to your computer via USB cable. If you're using Windows, open the Apple Devices app or iTunes if that isn't available. Or if you're using Mac, open the Finder. Do the force restart sequence on your iPhone, holding the side button until you see the connect to computer screen. Then locate your iPhone on your computer. When you see the option to update or restore, choose update and wait for the download to complete. If that didn't solve the issue, it's time to consider the factory reset. This is a drastic course of action which will format your phone, wiping all apps, software updates, and personal data. To do a factory reset without touchscreen use, go back to Finder, Apple Devices, or iTunes. Do the force restart sequence one more time, holding the side button until you see the connect to computer screen. But this time, you'll choose restore instead of update. After the restore is complete, you'll have the option to set up your device as new or restore from an iCloud backup if one is available. Screens are expensive to repair, so it's prudent to use a screen protector and phone case to keep your phone from sustaining preventable damage. However, some screen protectors don't fit quite right. If your screen stops responding after you installed a new screen protector, try removing it and seeing if that makes a difference. You may need a different brand. Similarly, low-quality iPhone cases can cause displays to become unresponsive. Remove the case and see if your touchscreen works without it. Of course, sometimes the answer is simply damage. While iPhones have IP68 ratings, meaning they're resistant to water and dust, they aren't completely waterproof, so taking one into the pool is still not a good idea. That rating depends on the phone remaining in perfect factory condition. Every time you knock it, drop it, accidentally throw it instead of your dog's ball, you make it likelier that IP68 rating gets 86'd. If this is the case for you, you might be able to take your iPhone to Apple for repair. You can reach out online, via phone, in person at an Apple store, or even via mail. Hopefully your touchscreen woes are less serious than that. Do you have any remedies for touchscreen issues we couldn't cover in our time today? Please share your tips below, and we will see you next time with more DIY in 5.